And we see affairs, 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 affairs. And of course, Musla, Muslim, Allah. So Freemasonry at the highest level worships Allah, who actually directly is Set. Symbol of the moon and the star. Well, Arthur Edward Waite says Babel represented a Masonic enterprise. Now, what does this mean? Now, let's get a little bit deeper into the story. We've seen that before as well, the Tower of Babel. Now, that's what the Tower of Babel looked like, supposedly. Notice that it is built as a spiral. These are all the representations that you find in the literature. There's another representation of the Tower of Babel. Notice the spiral way in which it goes up to the top. There's a whole host of them. Spiral, 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 circular. Here's a strange one, but they're all spirals. Most of them probably look like that. So that was a Masonic enterprise. Now, isn't that interesting? Let's look at this picture again. In an Islamic country, Mary on the spiral, standing on top. Here we have Holy Mary, Queen, circle with a dot in it. Do you remember what Albert Pike said that was? That was the generating principle, like the ship and the mast. Same thing. They use that symbol for Mary. Oh, here's another place. Can you see that over there? There she stands. This is in southern Africa, on the spiral. What is this? That's the Tower of Babel. There we see it from the front. This one over here, in Lebanon. I took this one myself in Lebanon. There she is, on top of the Tower of Babel. So who's going to be Queen of the New Babylon? Mary. But who is Mary? Mary is Isis. Is she? Here is this church where her figure is with this Phoenician ship over there. There you can see her silhouette through the window. And there's the painting of her. She is the Queen of Babylon. Let's ask Blavatsky whether this is so. Secret doctrine. It is mankind which has become the serpent of Genesis and thus causes daily and hourly the fall of sin, celestial Virgil, which thus becomes the celestial version, which thus becomes mother of gods and devils at one and the same time. She is the ever-loving, beneficent deity to all those who stir her soul and heart. That's the secret doctrine. She says, Lucifer is divine and terrestrial light, the Holy Ghost and Satan at one and the same time. So, Satan, Mary, one and the same thing. In Blavatsky's work, Isis Unveiled, she says, Isis, the Egyptian, had the following. Holy Isis, universal mother, mother of gods, mother of Horus, Nate, mother soul of the universe, virgin, sacred earth, mother of all virtues, illustrious Isis, Mirror Justice, Sacred Lotus, System of Astarte, Moon, Queen of Heaven, Model of all mothers, Isis is a virgin mother. Then she continues, in Hinduism, same thing. It's Holy Nari, Mariama, interesting. Mother of perpetual fecundity, mother of the incarnate God, mother of Krishna, eternal virginity, all the same features all the way through. Then we go to Isis. Roman Catholic litany of the verses. Same book. This is secret doctrine. At least Isis Unveiled. Holy Mary, Mother of Divine Grace, Mother of God, Mother of Christ, Virgin of Virgins, Morning Star. Very interesting. Mystical Rose, Queen of Heaven. All the same titles. Isis Mary. Now notice this is Isis Unveiled. This is Helena Petrovna Blavatsky speaking herself. When Cyril, the Bishop of Alexandria, oh well, what can you expect? Of course it was Alexandria. Had openly embraced the cause of Isis, the Egyptian goddess, and had anthropomorphized her into Mary, the Mother of God, and the Trinitarian controversy had taken place. From that moment, the Egyptian doctrine of the emanation of the creative God of Emphet began to be tortured in a thousand ways until the councils had agreed upon the adoption of it as it now stands. So there you have it. There it is. The Bishop of Alexandria made Isis into Mary. So it's the same old worship. So if you go into a Roman Catholic cathedral or a Roman Marian shrine, here I've photographed one in Europe, This is recent. I took this 5 weeks ago. This is brand new. It's nice to have some new slide. Prayer to the Star of the Sea. Oh, Mary, Star of the Sea. Who is the Star of the Sea? Who is the God of the Sea? It was Poseidon. It was Osiris. Oh, dear Mother, I now come to Thee with greatest confidence. The many miracles which had happened fill me, poor sinner, blah, blah, blah. Thou, O sweetest Mother, O amiable Star of the Sea, do not let me go away from here without being heard, etc., etc. Thou canst help me, for Thou art mightiest after God. I just put that in for the Goyim. They actually believe it is God. Here's this famous Pius, the same one who catapulted Adolf Hitler to power. 1950, Dogma of Mary's Ascension to Heaven. And here is the dogma. We declare that the Most Blessed Virgin Mary in the first moment of her conception was by the unique grace and privilege of God in view of the merits of Jesus Christ, the Savior of human race, preserved intact from all stain of original sin. Now, this doctrine is incredibly important because now Jesus has his merits because of his mother and not because of his father. Remember that. Jesus has the traits of his mother. Can I burn that sentence into your head? Jesus has the traits of his mother. That's what this doctrine teaches. I will give you the Protestant preachers saying exactly the same. Interesting. Here, Focus magazine, Maria soll Göttin werden. Mary must become a goddess. Surely the Catholic Church would not permit Mary to be openly called goddess? Weibliche Gottheit? Female goddess? Absolutely, why not? Millions of US Catholics want a godly Mary. Cardinal John O'Connor and also Pope John Paul II, a great Marian honorer, are not averse to the idea. There you go. Mary is God. Of course she's God to the insiders because she is, as Blavatsky said, what? Lucifer. She's Lucifer. All right. That's why in the King James Version we read in Genesis 3:15, and I will put enmity between thee and the woman and between thy seed and her seed, and it shall bruise thy head and thou shalt bruise his heel. Not even the RSV has dared to change that. Genesis 3:15, I will put enmity between you and the woman and between your seed and her seed. He shall crush your head and you shall bruise his heel. But the Catholics don't like it like that because the Douay Rheims online Bible, which is the Jesuit one, says, I will put enmities between thee and the woman and thy seed and her seed, and she shall crush thy head and thou shalt lie in wait for her heel. So now Mary is the one who crushes Jesus. It's the other way around. And now, here's a photograph of a Marian appearance in Saitun, Egypt. So the Muslims are looking this, and here's a fascinating book, Queen of Rome, Queen of Islam, Queen of All. So do we have the same religion here? Let's just check this out. Let's take the Roman Catholic website, Hearts R, Roman Catholic doctrine regarding Mary. This is their doctrine, not me speaking. The one holy Catholic and apostolic church is led by the Bishop of Rome, successor to Peter, the first pope, has always venerated the Blessed Virgin Mary, including her sinlessness. The church follows scripture, especially the New Testament, which she herself compiled as perfectly as she follows her tradition. For behold, henceforth all generations shall call me blessed. Luke 1:48. Then, this is still their paper. This is what the Catholics are writing. It is no surprise that the woman would triumph over the red dragon, for scripture says so at the very beginning. Refer Genesis 3:15, which states, and all will establish a feud between thee and the woman, between thy offspring and hers, and she is to crush her. Which one are they quoting? Which one are they quoting? The Catholic Jesuit one. Wow! Fascinating stuff. Let's continue. Same webpage. To Mary, the woman of scripture and mother of men, who keep the commandments and hold fast to the truth concerning Jesus. Oh, that's an interesting statement. That comparison will make such fun as we get a little bit later into Revelation. The church applies the beautiful words of wisdom, she the glow that radiates from eternal light, she the untarnished mirror of God, because Mary is full of grace. The church, through Pope Pius, has declared her as conceived immaculate, without sin. Very important. Mary has become known as the Immaculate Conception as a result of the apparition at Lourdes in 1851. She is immaculate. Jesus is sinless just because of her, not because of God, because of her. The Immaculate Conception, or the Immaculate Heart, Catholic Cyclopedia, Book 6.